I, a couple of months ago, experienced a bit of thinning within my hair, and in correlation to that, I had assumed that I was going bald. I thought that my hair was going away, and I was losing my fucking hair, and I didn't know what to do or what to say. I was in shock, okay? When I went to Europe about 3 months ago, approximately around that time, I was making TikToks left and fucking right, and I noticed them within one of the videos. I'll show you the video right now. I saw an extreme amount of thinning within my hair. Now, to be fair, I will admit my hair was significantly longer than it is right now, and you can make a couple of arguments, Kevin, don't worry, maybe it was just a bad angle, maybe your hair was wet. My hair was not wet, it was actually extremely fucking dry, extremely normal. So I was like, what the fuck is going on? There's a huge gap. I didn't know what to do, what to say. I was just really disappointed and actually really fucking sad about the situation. I said to myself, Kevin, you must do something now, because as most would know, or at least I would hope, it's actually easier to maintain and keep what you already have than to try to regain what you once had but already lost, okay? That's just a fucking sad truth, people. So I had to get onto a little regimen of mine, and I'll tell you guys my daily regimen right now, because this is what I do so far to, I guess you could say, of how I reversed what I once lost, which was not very much, but caught onto it very quickly. And also, in my best fucking possible abilities, will try my best to explain how to reverse and also maintain your hair. So, I'm gonna talk and discuss about the very few minor things that I have either stopped doing or am currently now doing within my daily routine to maintain the longevity and healthiness of my hair. So without further ado, let's begin. Step one. One of the biggest things I stopped using was all conditioners and shampoo products. Primarily, a product that I used quite frequently, I must say, is Head & Shoulders. I use this shampoo product very, very frequently within my life because of the fact that I suffer heavily from dandruff and dry, itchy skin. Why the fuck did I have that problem? I'll explain to you right now. See, the funny thing is I came up with a little theory of my own, and that's because of the fact that all my life, I actually never really even used shampoos or conditioners. Not recommending you to do that. I'm just saying, me personally, I actually, from the ages of when, you know, I first came out the fucking womb to up to maybe like 12 years old, 13 years old, I never really used, you know, shampoo, conditioner. I never fucking used it. Why is it that when I now use products that, well, I mean, typically, like, it's normal and you should use conditioners and shampoos in your hair. Why is it now that I'm having problems when I start using the things that people are recommending me to use? Well, there's a couple of reasonings as to why. I can't really conclude to the main reason as to why, but I mean, there's a fucking variety of reasons. The main reason is, well, there's certain allergic reactions that people, certain individuals have to certain products. You know, products such as Head & Shoulders here contain sulfates of some sorts, right? And basically what these sulfates contain and do is when you apply it to your hair and scalp, basically it strips away all the natural oils that your body needs within your hair to keep it and maintaining it healthy. So you're basically fucking yourself over, you dumb motherfucker. Don't worry, I made that mistake too. Hey guys, I'm taking a shit right now, so I'll cut you in the soon time. Did that make any sense? Actually, I think we need to rehearse that. Fuck. Hey guys, I'm taking a shit right now, so we're gonna take a little commercial break. See ya. Step two, I also use a lot of biotin within my day-to-day life. I consume it in not only pills, but I use it in products such as the conditioners and shampoos that I'm showing you right now. And yeah, I try to use and get as much biotin in my system as possible, because if you do not know, biotin, also known as vitamin B7, stimulates keratin production in hair and can increase the rate of follicle growth. And not only most effective, but if we want to talk about, you know, biotin in terms of volumes, the amount of biotin that you are getting in your system, I mean, consuming it in pill form is probably the best fucking choice, okay? And it also doesn't hurt to consume it within products such as, you know, shampoos and conditioners. So search on the internet, you know, shampoos and conditioners that contain biotin and apply it to your hair every now and then, because that doesn't fucking hurt, right? Now, what really causes hair loss? I mean, we don't just fucking magically lose our hair and poof, it just fucking runs away and disappears out of our body and never wants to come back. Like every fucking girl that I've ever talked to in my entire fucking life that just disappear on me and never give me an explanation as to why. What the fuck, man? Like, this dating game is fucking bullshit. Okay, so there's a hormone that releases in your body called DHT. It is a sex hormone derivative, and it's actually derived from testosterone. Now, fun fact, and I didn't know this until about 2 years ago, which actually pissed me the fuck off because I'm like, damn, that fucking sucks. If you work out and you're somebody who's very active, you know, for example, me, you know, I do bodybuilding. I focus on getting big, getting jacked, getting bitches. You know what I'm saying? But leave that last part out. That's irrelevant to this whole fucking situation and talk. Working out actually increases the production of DHT by approximately 10 to about 11%, which is a significant fucking increase, and it really does suck to know that because it's like, damn, like, I'm trying to get fucking jacked and you're telling me that that's, like, biting me in the ass? Like, what kind of shit is that, bro? Like, that's some fucking bullshit. Fuck, I ate too much Chipotle, boys. I ate way too much fucking Chipotle. DHT is a bitch. Because right now, doing what I'm doing, trying to get fucking jacked as shit, I'm over here causing myself some extra points to hair loss. Everything great comes with a cost, so. But honestly, it does make sense because working out in general, staying active, you know, going on runs, lifting weights, doing all that good shit, you're naturally going to increase your testosterone just a bit. And since DHT is derived from testosterone, it only makes sense that it does increase as well as testosterone increases. So it does make sense, you know, to be honest with you. So I'm not really, you know, I get it. There is a certain pill that you can consume every single fucking day, once per day, that can actually block your DHT from going to your scalp and, you know, messing with your hair follicles. And in conclusion, no hair loss, right? And wow, that's fucking phenomenal. What is it? It's actually called finasteride. Finasteride has been proven to block your DHT levels, but the problem with this is the fact that, well, like I said earlier, DHT is a sex hormone, but this is why I will probably not ever touch finasteride unless I'm in desperate fucking needs. But there's a symptom of where you can have erectile dysfunction and not be able to get up. I was actually talking to a guy at the gym a couple of weeks ago, and he was telling me how he actually takes finasteride, or he took finasteride, in other words, no longer takes it because of the fact that one day he was on a date with a really hot ass chick, and he said, according to her, she was like a fucking 10 out of 10 playboy model type girl. She was bad as fuck. Took her to the bed and couldn't get fucking hard. His dick was softer than a fucking cupcake. It couldn't get hard because of the fact that he was actually using finasteride, and one of the side effects of finasteride could be erectile dysfunction, and that fucking sucks because not having your cock hard where you need it at an all-time high, no pun intended, that is very unfortunate. And it's like, at that point, you just gotta say to yourself, what matters more, my hair or my boners?
I also apply minoxidil products within my scalp, 4 deep sprays in my hair, and I basically massage it. Massaging is the key thing you want to do here, because basically when you massage your scalp gently, not aggressively, because you're going to fucking counter and act basically what you're trying to fucking do. You're not trying to rip your hair out. You're trying to improve quality of hair follicles. And so adding more blood flow to the scalp will do that.
So basically what minoxidil does is it stimulates hair growth, okay? And a lot of people, actually, it's very prevalent in the world for people to use minoxidil on their fucking beards to, you know, grow into, you know, building a full beard, you know? And so it's actually, fun fact, not only used for that, but also for your hair. And it works both ways. The only side effect and con of minoxidil is as soon as you stop, if you stop using the product, you actually shed hair, okay? But that's just a little short process that doesn't last very long. So honestly, I just wouldn't recommend stopping. I just recommend consistently using it, because why would you stop if you're trying to do this whole fucking thing to maintain your hair?
Last but not least, what I've tend to been doing lately is I massage my scalp and hair very, very delicately and slowly after I take a shower, because when your hair is wet, that is when your hair is at its weakest point, okay? So massaging your hair, because most people tend to do this, I used to do this too, fucking grab the towel and fucking go mayhem on my fucking head. Do not fucking do that. You are going to ruin your hair. Do little dabs. Do little pouts and little massages. And yeah, that's the story of how I'm trying to maintain my hair. Listen, I need my fucking hair. I'm 5'7", I'm fucking mid as fuck, and I'm semi-jacked. So I need my fucking hair. Subscribe, peace.